We got you. We got you. And more to come. Clown, thug, crook, criminal.
That was the official statement of Congressman Jamal Bowman in response to the moment we've all been waiting for, the reveal of Trump's mugshot, or how I've been describing it, Trump's best impression of Zoolander. And the internet definitely had a field day leading up to and with the release of this image. First though, how did Trump feel about getting his mugshot taken? He went on Newsmax to air his grievances. Let's watch.
Mr. President, the fourth time you were in custody today. It's totally absurd in my opinion, but what was it like? How did they treat you? What was the experience like today in jail?
Terrible experience. I came in, I was treated very nicely, but it is what it is. I took a mugshot, which I never heard the words mugshot. That wasn't, didn't teach me that at the Wharton School of Finance. And I have to go through a process. It's election interference. You know that better than anybody. You cover it so well. You just did a fantastic job, I have to tell you, for the listeners. Fantastic job, Greg. But it's a very sad experience, and it's a very sad day for our country.
A mugshot being just one of the many things that Trump didn't learn at the Wharton School of Business. Now, he was talking about how it was a terrible experience for him. We knew that he was going to capitalize on this. So first, he used the mugshot to mark his glorious return to Twitter, or we guess we could call it his debut on X. Let's take a look.
Seconds ago, this is great news. He's back on Twitter. President Trump on Twitter, he just tweeted the mugshot. Election interference, never surrender, DonaldJTrump.com. Mugshot, August 24th, 2023. Welcome back. The last tweet, I believe, was January 6th.
I'm sorry, I just love that you can see him visibly getting turned on by Trump's mugshot. So let's take a closer look at the post that he is, his return to Twitter post. It's a picture of his mugshot and then election interference, never surrender, DonaldJTrump.com. Of course, especially ironic considering he posted it directly after he surrendered. But as Greg Kelly noted, this was his first post on Twitter since his ban following the January 6th riot in 2021. Now, we'll point out also that he's been suspended from Twitter. However, it was lifted after Elon Musk purchased the platform, but Trump, ever the petty individual he is, opted to stick to his Truth Social platform until yesterday. Now, in addition to using this mugshot as his comeback to Twitter, we said he was going to capitalize on it, and capitalize on it he did, because he released this merchandise on his campaign website last night. There it is. Although if you're interested in purchasing merchandise, I would suggest you head over to Shop TYT and stay far, far away from Trump's campaign website. Of course, Don Jr. always running right after his father is getting in on the grifting action. He posted this. Free Trump merch. I'm sorry, I have to pause for a second. The fact that Don Jr. refers to his father as Trump is the funniest thing in the world to me. That's your dad. You just refer to him as Trump. He did it on the, after the debates, he did it. He did it on the news yesterday, and he did it in this tweet. I think it just goes so far to show how little of a relationship there is between the two of them. I'm sorry, but he continued on. To be clear, all profits from this on my web store are going to be donated to the Legal Defense Fund to fight the tyranny and insanity we're seeing before us. Unlike many, I won't try to profit from this, but will do what I can to help. Of course, he had to point out that he's not going to try to profit like all of the other grifters in the right wing. Echo spare. We've got some more about the reactions from this, but first, Cenk, initial thoughts on the mugshot.
Yeah, so let's put it back up because I thought the same thing you did, Ray. First thing I tweeted was blue steel. I think that's what he's going for. But then that made me think, stop the steal. And then secondly, as I look at that tweet, it says never surrender. Well, that's kind of ironic, right? Because that's literally the picture of you surrendering to authorities. Second of all, there's another surrender in there that's implicit. He's giving up on Truth Social. When he posts on Twitter, that puts him in violation of a number of things for Truth Social. Truth Social, when it first got released and was going to be involved in a SPAC, etc., it could have been worth billions of dollars. For a brief moment, that was very, very real. Now they had to play it right from there on to actually deliver on the billions of dollars. But from then on, all they did was one mistake after another, until now he goes back on Twitter and has basically surrendered Truth Social. It's now worthless. So that's two surrenders in one picture. Well played, Donald Trump, as usual. And then I love the reference to Wharton, right? For a couple of reasons. Number one, he's like, I didn't learn mugshot. I never heard mugshot. Really, you never heard the word mugshot? Okay, all right, at Wharton. Number one, why would you hear it in a business school? That's kind of a weird thing. But if you were gonna hear it at any business school, it would be Wharton. And I know because I went there, we had a wall of fame. And so many people on that wall of fame got arrested that it became a wall of shame, and then they took it down. So yeah, we've heard it was insider trading after insider trading, more like sleazy things like that Donald Trump did. Look, of course, I went there. I'm perfectly proud of it. I'm not proud of those guys, right? I'm not proud of that record. But there's a giant difference between me and Donald Trump. I earned my way in. And his daddy got him in because he's a spoiled little brat, and that's why he still hides his grades. I always find that hilarious. What kind of a deeply pathetic, insecure man hides his grades from college and high school? So I actually challenged Donald Trump to a lot of money. Let's go. My grades are public. You see them. All you got to do is beat them, and then you'll collect out my money. But of course he doesn't because he's pathetic. And he was, as one of the professors said, the worst goddamn student I have ever had in my life. That's because he's a spoiled little brat. His daddy got him in by however methods that they used. And that's why all of his grades were a miserable failure. He's a total loser, can't read more than two pages. So now that gets to the deepest irony here. People are like celebrating this at MAGA. I mean, he said, if I shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue, I can get away with it. That would turn out to be the one true thing that he said, right? And now MAGA's acting like, oh yeah, if he shot someone on Fifth Avenue, then that makes it really cool. And I might shoot someone on Fifth Avenue. Well, I'm worried about it. Or I might at least pretend to shoot someone on Fifth Avenue so I can have a mugshot too, because having a mugshot and being a criminal is like the greatest thing. From the party of law and order, if you say so. Jordan?
I think you touched on something I wanted to explore, and that is people just projecting what they already believed onto the situation. For Democrats, they've been waiting for a Trump mugshot for years. All of his criminality, everything that he has done, they have been waiting for this moment. And I think it was probably not as fulfilling as some might have thought, because now you just wait for a lengthy legal proceeding that might get extended. Who knows what the outcome might be? And like you're saying, for Republicans, it was, this is awesome. He's so based. He's so awesome. Look how great he looks here. And then you saw some really weird, like, racial interplay with some of the commentary talking about how this makes him look like he's like leaning into the thug life. They had people were photoshopping him doing the blood hand symbol. Just really weird when you think about all of the context here. And the only, as Ray and I were talking before we went live, the only person in that camp who was indicted and booked and is black is still in jail. Everyone else, all of the other white people are out free. So you have to think about the racial dynamics in this issue too, and the commentary in support of Trump. It all feels very weird.
Right. And just to that point, I couldn't not mention Dinesh D'Souza's tweet where he said that that it's a status symbol in urban black communities. And then he said that Trump is like the king of our culture, as if Dinesh D'Souza is a member of urban black communities. And then he had the gall to compare Trump to Tupac. I mean, it's so silly.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.